Hello everyone, welcome back to Call of Cthulhu Dark Corners of the Earth. I'm feeling a lot better today compared to last time where I felt kind of dizzy and tired and just weird and out of it, but now I am fully recovered from whatever the hell was happening. I still don't know what was happening to me, but I'm fine now. And I have some very mind-blowing information to deliver, at least it was mind-blowing to me. I don't know if you'll find it the same, but what I'm drinking right now... What I'm drinking right now is chai tea. And here's what's mind-blowing that I discovered. I'm going to deliver some very important information to you. Something I think everyone should know before I get into the game. So hold on, we're going to interrupt Call of Cthulhu Dark Corners of the Earth to talk about tea. I saw a recipe for how to make your own chai tea, and it blew my mind just how easy it is. I didn't even use the recipe. I just saw that the recipe existed, got the basic idea, and just did it on my own. It turns out, chai tea is extremely easy to make very, very cheaply. What I did is I just combined some ginger powder, cinnamon powder, some cloves, and some nutmeg. And that's it. Those four spices. Mix those four spices in with some black tea. Doesn't particularly matter what kind of black tea. I used an Irish breakfast tea, English breakfast tea, whatever kind of... I'm sure tea connoisseurs will hate me for saying this, but any type of black tea is basically the same. At least to me it is. So mix those four herbs with some tea. Brew it, and there you go. You have chai tea. That's it. It's that cheap. You don't need to buy any special anythings. Just four herbs. Combine them. I just keep a bottle of it, just pre-mixed, and just put in like a teaspoon for one cup. Teaspoon of that plus a normal single bag of tea and you're good. It's freaking amazing. Chai tea is amazing, seriously. If you haven't had chai tea before, give it a try. It's warm, it's aromatic, has this wonderful soothing, just, it's amazing. I even added some imitation vanilla extract to it, so it's actually vanilla chai tea. It's so good, and it's so cheap, and it's so easy to make. Alright, I hope everyone enjoyed my talk about chai tea. Let's get into the game. What better time to talk about chai tea than when you're about to do an assault on a town that's under martial law?
The esoteric order of Dagon. If you aim weapons versus...
Have your men been able to determine the location of this old smuggling route?
Not yet. Our intelligence estimates the most likely site would be further downstream. The Monuxet is frozen over, so we should be just fine on foot. Let's get moving.
All right.
Move out, Marines.
Lead the way. Do I have a weapon? Yes, I have a... I only have a pistol. Okay, I only have a pistol. Okay, I'm being prevented from moving, so I'm guessing something bad's going to happen. Or never mind, they just wanted me to wait.
Keep your eyes peeled and your weapons ready.
My eyes have been freshly peeled. They're bleeding, but other than that, I think I'm fine. Hold on. What kind of a walking on snow sound effect am I hearing? Listen to his footsteps. It sounds like I'm walking on eggshells or something. Where do I... Oh, here we go. Oh, shit. Wow, I'm not good at providing backup, am I? Uh-oh, reload. Okay, come on, man. Come on. I'm going. Are you coming? Get out of the way. Oh wow, I'm losing my. Oh shit. I got out of the way and I was rewarded with death for that. Okay, I'm not waiting for him. I'm just gonna go. I'm going to continue to walk on eggshells. Let me guess, we're back to the beginning. Of course. And because it's overly scripted, I have to wait for them to finish talking before I can move past them, right?
Move out, Marines! Secure the area!
Yes.
Yes, sir! You heard the man. Move out. Hide. You take point.
Thank you!
Keep your eyes peeled and your weapons ready.
How much ammo do I have, actually? 34 shots, okay. I'm not... it's a pretty good amount of ammo, but I shouldn't just waste it. Especially not since it's the only weapon I have. God, this chai tea is good. Mmm.
I'll be right behind you, Jack. Move out!
See if I can headshot him from here. Oh, wait a minute. I'm not even supposed to help him. Never mind. Okay, let's go. He said, hurry up, Jack. Yeah. I'm right behind you. Okay. Okay, well, it looks like where the ice is dark is probably where it breaks. Yes, it is. Is that a graphical glitch, or is it intended to be extremely obvious where it's going to break? No shit! You say that after I've already been running for my life. I think I'm being shot at. Oh, they're gonna fall into the water. That's good. Convenient for me. Oh, shit. That was close. Okay. I'm good. Something waiting for me in a cave. Ah, there we go, someone else alive. I thought they had disappeared.
They're all dead, aren't they?
They were trapped. There was nothing anyone could have done.
Damn it! I tried to tell him, but the corporal wouldn't listen. They just wanted to slaughter those things.
What's your name, soldier?
Private Parker. Private Joe Parker.
Well, Parker, it looks like you found the old smuggling entrance.
The door's frozen over. I already tried to open it. But it's stuck fast. We'll have to melt the ice. You operate the flamethrower. I'll cover the door.
Well, if it's stuck fast, I'm gonna unstick it slow. I mean, wait, what? That's a flamethrower? It looks like a rusted propane canister. That thing does not look in good condition. Alright, come on. Oh, okay.
Hold it.
Don't open that. He's dead. If I just saw that there was something there, why didn't I...
Shit.
Why didn't I say something? I could have just said, hey, don't open the door. There's a fish thing that's gonna grab your ass and kill you. Welp, he's dead. Oh, I shouldn't be going towards it. Wait a minute. I can't kill it. What is that? Is that a deep one or something else? I just realized that I don't think I can kill it. I think I need to burn it. It's like a mini Cthulhu. It's like a Cthulit. Or Cthulet. Come on, Cthulhet. Come on. Wait, what? It's going back? What? I don't understand. Is it gonna come back, or is it gone for... Did I imagine it? No, I didn't imagine it. No, I can't. I don't think I can hurt it. It's hard to see if I can see a blood splatter past the smoke. No, I think I need to burn it. Okay, I'm gonna burn it when it just gets here, even though I wasn't really out far enough. Still, let's give that a shot. Come on. Okay. Did that... What? I am super, super confused. Like, do I have something in my inventory? No. Does it kill me if I touch it? I don't get it. Okay, it's trying to kill me, that's for sure. No, it's not even bleeding. What? Okay, this scene's kind of lost its impact at this point. Oh! I didn't trigger the script right. Okay, it's dying, I get it. Please die. Okay, that's yet another example of an incredibly overly scripted sequence. That reminds me again, it reminds me a lot of Another World. Where it's like, I mean, imagine this, like, imagine them planning the scene. I just imagine that they had a scene in mind, right? That a cool movie scene, okay? You talk to that, soldier, and then you see the vision of the thing behind the door, and then the soldier goes up to the door, and it gets killed by the thing behind the door that you just saw. It drags him further in and starts to eat him. You go in to see what happened to him, thinking, oh, maybe you can save him, but no. He's dead, and the thing that ate him comes for you. So you walk back, out the door, and you goad it into coming for you, and then you use the flamethrower on it, and it burns. But you have to do it just right, or the scene doesn't trigger properly. Okay, bye. I mean, in cases like that, you just end up having to just spend all of your time trying to figure out what the game expects you to do. It takes you out of the game so much. How can this game be so amazing and yet so horribly designed in so many ways? It's so confusing. If only I could have done something to save him. Oh, wait, you mean I could have just said, hey, don't open that door with the monster behind it? You mean I could have saved him? Oh. Well, shit. That kind of makes it a pointless sacrifice. It wasn't even a sacrifice. Just a pointless death. He had C4 on him? I guess I'll just take that.
A hefty chunk of dynamite.
Or dynamite, sorry. What the hell am I hearing? Looks like a jail. Okay, let's check this out first.
That won't work. The lock's badly rusted. That won't work. The lock's badly rusted.
What if they jailed up here? I guess I have max rifle ammo? Yeah, I guess I can only hold 30. It's weird. I've had the rifle ammo for, like, it seems the entire game, but I've never actually found a rifle. What is that? Good, I can't open it. I'm glad. What is that? I don't know. I don't even really want to know.
Jack? Is that you?
Mackie, where do they keep the keys to the cells?
I don't know for sure. Probably somewhere up in the main hall. What the blazes is going on?
A few hours ago, the government sanctioned a full-scale operation into Innsmouth. It seems you were right about the contagion.
I knew it. Why the delayed assault on the order? We have to arrest Robert Marsh now.
They can't breach the doors. Anyone who gets close is driven mad.
The guards were discussing some mural that Robert Marsh had etched onto the main doors. They said it was powered by a sacred ceremony to the Old Ones. Whatever the hell that means.
We have to stop that ceremony. Sit tight, Mackie. I'll be right back.
Anyone who approaches the doors is driven mad. Well, that won't be a problem for me because I'm already crazy. And I was just talking about not having a rifle. Hello. What are you? What kind of a rifle are you?
It's a large bronze key.
I don't know what kind of a rifle this is, but it's beautiful. Ooh, look at that. That is going to be so good for headshots. Much better than this. And I'm guessing it probably takes down enemies in one headshot, unlike the pistol, which I think takes two. It looks like the deep ones are going crazy. Look at them, it's like thrashing about. It looks like it's in pain, and the other ones sound like they're in pain. Wee, crazy mouse sensitivity. Come on back down, there we go. And for some reason, after I save a game, my FPS goes way down to 30. And then afterwards, like right now, it shoots back up to 150. I don't know why, and because the game's sensitivity and many other things, it seems, are tied to your FPS, it makes your mouse sensitivity way higher when you have low FPS. I don't know why. It's a pretty bad idea to code things like that based on your FPS. What is that writhing mass of stuff? What is that? And what's in here? Nothing. Oh, they're starfishes. Okay. They're demonic starfishes that want to kill me. I'm just gonna keep going. Fuck off!
Door is covered in a hostile strain of starfish.
Yeah, they're very hostile, and they apparently can jump. They're face-hugging starfish. Alright, so I need to blow this up, don't I? Yeah, alright. I'm just gonna take the damage. I don't think Can I avoid them? Wait a minute. I need to use it on the barrels, don't I?
This fuse will only last a couple of seconds. I better find cover, and quickly.
That was not a couple of seconds, that was more like 5 to 10. Not that I'm complaining about giving... Okay, loading screen. Not that I'm complaining about having too much time to get away from danger. This game has loading screens in the weirdest times. You just walk through a doorway that you just blew open and suddenly loading screen. Alright, I hear some demonic praying.
I better watch my step. This place could be crawling with guards.
Could be? You just saw that it is. That's not a could be, that's a definitely be.
There's nothing of any interest in the painting. There's nothing of any interest in the painting. I can feel a draft of air from behind this bookcase.
And I could see an entire new place behind it, so it's not a very well-hidden secret.
I can feel a draft of air from behind this bookcase. Books and ancient manuscripts, most of them in foreign or strange languages.
Okay, so there's some way to activate this. Wait, can I just push it? Oh, never mind. Okay, let's explore the rest of this place, though, before I go there. Oh shit, I didn't even see that. A bloody knife. Can I actually use it? Oh. Yeah, I'm not gonna be using a knife. I think I'll stick with my rifle.
The door's bolted shut. It's locked. The fire is barely enough to counter the freezing temperature.
Wait, what? No. Jack Walters, that is not how you say it. The fire is barely enough to counter the freezing... Wait, what did he say?
Except for the burning flames and hot coals, the fireplace is empty.
No. Say it again.
The fire is barely enough to counter the freezing temperature.
You mean, the fire is barely enough to counter the freezing temperature. You're saying it all wrong, Jack. Oh, hello, box art for the game.
There's nothing of any interest in the painting. I'll need the combination before I can open it.
No, don't be silly.
A few assorted documents and letters lie on the desk, but nothing of any significance. The door's bolted shut.
Okay, they are going to see me. If I just run out there, okay. I'm gonna close that. Oh god, no. Did not mean to close it from that side. There we go. Okay. Let's check out that secret place before I go out there. Into danger.
It won't open. It's a hidden passage.
Yes, Jack, I figured that out like 5 minutes ago. I am completely full on medical supplies, nice. Oh god, I'm going insane. Just by being near this place, I'm getting fisheye.
It won't budge.
Alright. So, even the secret passage leads to the same place, just through a different route.
It won't budge.
Unfortunately, I'm approaching this from an extraordinarily well-lit room. Something tells me I'm gonna be seen. Hold on, let me take a lucky sip of chai tea. Mmm. It's so good! Wait a minute, can I silently kill enemies with my knife? Can you actually do stealth kills?
I don't like this one bit.
Maybe you can do stealth kills. I have no idea if you can or not. I don't know if I ever tried that every time I, you know, played the game previously. Nope! Wow, you have bad aim, dude. The combat in this game proves, once again, caution is not needed. I have an excess amount of ammo and medical stuff. And enemies are apparently unable to hit you from 10 feet away with a Tommy gun. Okay, who wants to fight me? I hear someone wigging out. It sounds like their pathfinding is bugging somewhere. But I don't know where they are. Alright, you know, there's no reason to use stealth. There's absolutely zero reason to use stealth. Goodbye. Goodbye.
A large decorative vase.
Yeah, it's fascinating. Another key.
It's an old rusty key. A few assorted documents and letters lie on the desk, but nothing of any significance. It's a portrait of one of the Marsh family.
Pretty bad portrait, seems to be extremely stretched. Although that might just be because this is meant to be not widescreen. But no, that looks stretched far beyond what just stretching to widescreen would do.
The door's bolted shut.
Alright, so that opens there. Might as well open this. Alright, obviously I can't get through there. It's covered by some sort of mystical force field.
The doorway is sealed by some mystical force.
Field.
Being this close to the doors is making my head pound.
Okay, let's not stay around that. Alright, I think it's time to go upstairs. Yep, alright, let's go upstairs. Okay, that's gonna be a bit of a challenge. Never mind, let's not go upstairs. Where do I go? I have two keys, right? No, I have one. An old rusty key. Alright, there's gotta be a locked door somewhere. Where does this go? Oh.
Won't budge.
I don't think I have to actually use the key.
It won't open.
No.
It won't budge.
I'm sure I probably already encountered and I just don't remember it. Oh,
it's
there we go.
Unlocked. They're just old storage shelves. They're just old storage shelves.
Alright, upper level, here we go. Oh shit, it closed behind me. Okay, I'm stuck here. And there's absolutely no cover. Alright, here we go. Whoa! Look at this! It's a weird, like, watery look on the walls. Actually, not just on the walls, everything! It's almost like we're inside of an aquarium or something, or an aquarium is supposed to be this stuff, but it doesn't actually look like an aquarium. There's nothing there. Well, it's obviously looks like a portal.
I don't understand the purpose of this archway.
It's a portal. Yeah, it's a portal. It's definitely a portal to somewhere. Alright, before I go there, let's explore the rest over here. Alright, here's where I can op-
Stop where you are!
Wait. Wait, what?
What is it?
I wish I didn't trigger that. Do I need to do something? Nope, I guess that's it. I withstood the assault of two enemies. Oh my god.
The thing in the way. What? Cthulhu!
popping heads like melons. Please come back. I'm not done with you yet. Alright, fine, whatever.
It's some sort of winch mechanism. It must be for raising the stone disc. The winch is operated by hand.
Yes, I understand that. Could you maybe operate it? Of course you can.
Some sort of winch mechanism. It must be for raising the stone disc.
Where did he go?
Okay, there we go. The AI is so dumb in this game. It's embarrassing.
It won't budge.
Okay, now we go over here. How much ammo do I have? Quite a bit.
The door's bolted shut.
Is that a crying girl? Is it a real girl or is it Ramona? Oh, God. Where the hell? Yeah, let's use the pistol. How am I so good at aiming? I don't think I'm normally particularly good at aiming, but for some reason I'm doing a really good job in this game. Where'd the other guy go? He's not dead. I know you're not dead, dude. Come out. Now you're dead. It's Ramona. The lovely little stained glass thing. I think I can break it, but let me read everything else first.
The fireplace is empty.
Wait, Jack. No, that's not right.
The fireplace is empty.
Jack, don't you mean the empty fireplace is not even close to enough to keep out the freezing cold winds?
It looks like the diary of Robert Marsh.
It should be juicy. Why does it have the Book of Dagon as not read? I already read it. I have been reading my own diary, right? Yeah. Alright. Diary of Robert Marsh. The translation of the tablets is progressing well. Soon, the word of Father Dagon shall be known to us in its entirety, as it is to those below in... what? I don't know. Then, armed with knowledge of the divine purpose, we shall be able to take our place beneath the waves on equal terms, and the grand design set in motion more than 80 years past shall draw toward its completion. Allah Dagon. Allah Hard... Is that Allah? Like Allah? I forgot how to pronounce that. Whatever. Dagon, Hydra, blah blah blah. Worship. Poor Darwin, to be so completely wrong. For the higher forms of life are those who return to the sea, not those who forsook it for the land. And in generations to come, as the last remaining taint of human blood leaves our strain, we shall ascend to true knowledge and true power in the love and service of Father Dagon and Mother Hydra. But there is much still to be done, before that glorious future is assured. The outsiders could still ruin everything. The one will be sacrificed, but the other who has come looking for him must be dealt with. Innsmouth must remain undisturbed until everything is complete. That which eluded my ancestor Obid on his death in 1878 shall not escape me. If only Sebastian understood things as I do, his science, his meddling in the surface world, how meaningless they all are. Once we take our place alongside the Elder Ones, how small his endeavors will seem. But he has been deaf to the word of Dagon, no matter how I have tried. Perhaps upon his return, with the translations, so much further advanced, I can make him see the truth. Wait, what about this? The one will be sacrificed, but the other who has come looking for him must be dealt with. Who is the one that's being sacrificed? Because I'm guessing I'm the other one who has come looking for him. Right? Actually, I don't know. I'm not sure. Alright. Hi, Ramona. Well, that's not good for my sanity.
An ugly stone statue. It suits the place.
Yes, it does.
The fountain's dried up. It's just a statue.
Damn it. I thought there'd actually be something behind there. Oh, never mind, here's one. Okay, that'll take me inside of the locked, bolted door. Wait a minute. Wait. If there's a window there and the only exit is through a bolted door, who bolted it? You can't bolt it from the outside, and no one could have escaped except by going through the door. Which means it would be unbolted, or by going through the window. But there is a window here. So unless someone removed the window or broke it, and then left the room and leaving it locked, and then somebody replaced the window, this is impossible.
Some smokes and a desk lamp. Not much of any interest.
Some interesting symbols.
The large mural is engraved with text from some ancient language. There's nothing of any interest in the painting. There's nothing of any interest in the painting.
The fact that he keeps saying there's nothing of any interest in the painting makes me think there's one where there is something of interest in it. Actually, didn't Mackie mention something about a painting? I don't remember what he said, though.
I'll need to decipher the symbols to understand it.
Wait a minute. What about my book?
The Book of Dagon is missing a few of the symbols. It's a prayer of some sort, but I can't complete the translation.
Okay, so I need another book. Or something. So, wait, where does that leave me? Oh, yeah, there's a bunch more doors, never mind.
Won't budge.
I'm not done yet.
Won't budge.
There is still the whole stone disc thing.
It won't open.
Never mind, it's all... none of it works. Alright, I might need to see if I can crank that handle.
It won't budge.
One that Jack seemed to like to remark upon as being hand-crankable, but didn't want to actually crank it. If I use the Book of Dagon here, not that it would do anything, that wouldn't make any sense. Nah. But wait, even if I... Wait a minute, what is this?
It's a small stone plaque engraved with text from some ancient language. According to the text, only a prayer to Dagon can break the seal.
Alright, prayer. I don't even remember what I was saying. Oh yeah, even if I could crank this, I can't even get into the room, right? Because the only way is blocked. I need to do the prayer first.
The winch is operated by hand.
So... this is incomplete. So... what?
It won't open.
What do I do? Funny thing is, I remember getting stuck here last time I played. It's funny how we keep repeating the same mistakes, even though I knew the solution because I got past it, obviously. But I just don't remember what it is. Still, there's not that much to explore here, so... the solution needs to be nearby. Maybe I should check the paintings.
This old painting is kind of sinister. There's nothing of any interest in the painting.
Okay, that's new.
From what I can figure, most of these volumes cover the occult.
I'll need more information to complete the translation. There's nothing of any interest in the painting.
Alright, didn't Mackie say something about there being a mural? Like in the main hall or something? The main something or other? Is there a painting down there? Wait a minute, can I even go down? Oh. You can. Good to know. Alright, no paintings here. There are paintings here. But I can't examine it.
This must be the mural Mackie was talking about.
Wait, what? This?
I won't be able to open the doors. They're tightly sealed.
Wait, what? How is this a mural? I do not like the things that I'm hearing here. I'm gonna leave. Okay, I'm... Wait a minute. Have I been down here? I know I came from there at one point.
I won't be able to open the door with this barrier in the way. According to the text, only a prayer to Dagon can break the seal. The doorway is sealed by some mystical force.
Okay, yeah, so I'm not exactly sure what to do, so I'm gonna cut to when I figure out what to do, so I'll be right back.
Yes, that's it.
There we go.
The safe holds a pistol, a crumpled scroll of paper, and a heavily bound manuscript embossed with the word Panape.
So this is what I forgot. Okay. Yeah, I was looking through my notes. I was thinking that the last thing I discovered was the diary of Robert Marsh. And I was thinking, what in here could I possibly use? And I realized there's a date. The death of Obed Marsh in 1878. I realized when I saw that, I thought, oh, that's a combination. Then I remembered, oh yeah, the safe that I completely forgot about. So, there we go. Did I just pick up a pistol, or was that like some super pistol? Nope, just a normal pistol. Okay. Wait a minute. Never mind, it's Mackie. It's Mackie's pistol. I guess I should give it back to him. And I have a note, and I have a short manuscript titled A la Dagon, for some glyphs missing from the Book of Dagon. Okay. Okay. Here we go. Dagon and Panape scripture. This scroll of paper holds a prayer to Dagon. Translated into English, it reads, "In thy name, let us behold the Father. From the depths of the waters I come, and from the depths the deep ones also have come. Hail to the ancient dreams. Hail to Dagon." Panape scripture. This heavy-bound manuscript is embossed with the word Panape. It claims to be a reprinting of an original manuscript written by Captain Abner Ezekiel Hogue in 1734, describing his encounters with a strange cult in the islands of the Pacific. Hogue claims that the islanders worship, and even interbreed with, strange beings from the sea, and reproduces much of the lore of this unspeakable religion. There are harrowing passages that tell of unspeakable sacrifices by which these deep ones are appeased, and of objects cast into the sea to summon them. By means of the correct rituals and offerings, they can be induced to bring fantastically worked jewelry of gold for the islanders, although this conforms to their own strange anatomy rather than that of any human being. Hogue recounts the islanders' tales of fantastic underwater cities, constructed according to some obscure and inhuman laws of geometry and architecture. Some legends tell of islanders transforming into sea creatures as they grow old, and going to live forever beneath the sea. The greatest of the deep ones, Father Dagon and Mother Hydra, are said to be fantastically old, hailing from a time before the first human walked upright. Strangely, he stresses that these stories are not primitive metaphors for an afterlife, like similar tales from other island cultures, but recounts them as actual fact. He claims to have seen and conversed with these creatures himself, and witnessed several of the islanders' ceremonies and offerings to them. Well, I have no doubt they're real. None at all. Alright. Back upstairs. Somewhere. Here we go. Okay. Now, do I need to go to the glyphs? Or can I just use this on a door? No, I need to go to the glyphs. Yeah, because that's the prayer. The thing on the door is just telling me to do the prayer, right?
According to the text, only a prayer to Dagon can break the seal.
Yeah, the thing by the door just says it's locked, basically. It's not actually the prayer itself. The prayer is in here. I was just kidding. It's in here. Yes.
The prayer to Dagon reads, Bahuin and Kugnath, Fanu Nayemna, Vunag Lazai, Vunag Lazana, Kulth, Ia Rigazengaro, Ia Dagon.
Did it work? Okay, now I know it's Ia, not Alar or anything like that. Ia. Aya Dagon, Aya Hydra. Well, that's still there, but maybe the other doors have been unlocked?
The Huin and Kugna.
Oh, I see.
Nayemna, Vunag Lazai, Vunag Lazana, Kulth, Aya Rigazengaro. Dagon.
Boom. And boom. Two different kinds of boom. One was a satisfaction having opened the door boom, and the other was a literal explosion. Wow, how did that miss? How did that miss? How did you miss? And I'm out of ammo. Okay, that was a pathetic fight from multiple perspectives. Pathetic performance on my part, and pathetic aiming on his part. And it looks like I got shot in the face. Alright. Now, what about the other doors? Can I open the main door with my prayer? Probably not. That seems too easy.
Being this close to the doors is making my head pound.
Okay, yeah, definitely not. Alright, well, let's go back up to the winch thing, hand crank. That up there. Oh, wait a minute, there's something here.
These look like the keys to the cells. Now I can free Maggie.
Ah.
The book contains details of a blasphemous ceremony.
Actually, if I want to go back to Maggie, which I do, obviously. Not that I particularly care for him. But I probably have to. If I want to go back, I should stay on the ground floor. Okay. Mackie, I've got the keys and I've got your gun. Yeah. You've waited like 20 minutes. I think you can wait 10 seconds.
Well done, Jack. Did you find the ceremony?
Not exactly. I think it's being held in some underground chamber. A great stone disc is covering the entranceway. I'm gonna need your help to get inside.
I'll need a gun.
No problem. It didn't take much detective work to figure out who this belongs to.
First-rate work, Jack. Let's go.
Are you actually going to come with me? Okay. Well, as I know from the past, and from any horror game ever, anyone who tags along with you is going to die very soon. Pretty much. Just watch out. Watch your step. Watch out for the evil starfish. They're probably just goo now that I... What the hell? Once again, we see the respawning enemies rear their ugly head again. Hey!
Damn it, I've lost Mackie. I better catch up with him before he gets into trouble.
Do I have to? See, I don't have to catch up with him. He got here. Where's the thing? Which way is the thing? Here? Yeah, here we go. Seriously, respawning enemies. Alright, I'm just gonna pistol these. Because I have maximum pistol ammo.
Maximum pistol.
Okay. Did you see that, Mackie? That was first-rate detective work. Actually, I didn't detective anything, I just shot someone, but... Mackie? I'm here. Come here, boy.
Yeah.
Okay, Mackie, good Mackie. No, bad Mackie. Mackie, come back. Mackie. Come here. Good boy. Okay, Mackie, fuck you.
It's some sort of winch mechanism. It must be for raising the stone disc.
No shit.
Okay, Mackie, this is it. You raise the lid and I'll crash the party.
Good luck, Jack.
Oh wow, he actually didn't die. He's just ditching me very soon, which is good, because I don't want to have him near me at all. He is nought but a liability. Mackie? Don't drop it on my head, okay? Okay. Oh god. I'm getting closer to it. Closer to the source. Now I'm locked in. What am I gonna find in here? Oh god.
It's the outsider. Destroy
him. Oh shit. Really? Is that it?
Robert Marsh leaving the thermo. I'd better get after him.
That was a really, really weak boss fight. Wow, okay. Stand in place and shoot both. Well, I guess it wasn't really a boss fight, but that was meant to be epic. That was meant to be epic, but all I did was stand in place and shoot them all in the head. Oh god, I'm going insane down here.
Doors are tightly sealed.
Alright, so we got a puzzle here. And I have to solve a puzzle while I'm going insane. Alright, Dagon.
It's a statue of Dagon.
Alright, bunch of symbols.
I can't handle this anymore.
Now this is going to take some detective work.
The mural is broken. But I can still make out some of the symbols. My head's pounding. The mural is engraved with text from some ancient language. It reads, to leave the temple, bow to the deity of the order.
There's no hope here.
The deity of the order?
There are things.
The god of the order. What is the god of the order?
I can hear something. I'm gonna die.
I mean, they worship Dagon Hydra. And Cthulhu, right?
I'll never make it out of here alive.
Well, I'm pretty sure it's Cthulhu. Cthulhu would be above everything else, wouldn't it?
Get out of here.
And plus, in the visions that I kept seeing, something was worshipping Cthulhu, so...
It's a statue of Cthulhu. It's a statue of Hydra.
Alright, so there's a thing on the back. Alright. Different symbols with a button that corresponds to that symbol. Alright, so this is probably the order I need to do it in. I'm gonna give this a shot for like a minute, and if it takes too long, I'm just going to cut out after a bit. So let me try this for like a minute, and if it doesn't go too well, then I'll cut to when I figure it out. Alright, so this is like a... Okay, well, I'm not going to assume anything crazy, alright? I'm not going to overcomplicate this. Let's just do what it looks like. I believe this is the deity of the order. Or deity of the order. These are the three symbols. Let's just write them down and press them in that order. Alright, so we got, like, the Triforce thing. Cool. And then we have the other thing with the circle in the center. And then you got, like, the twisty thing with, like, a pit in the center. Okay. Could it be this easy? Alright, Triforce. And this thing next. And bow to the deity. Okay, yeah, there's obviously more to it. I didn't think it'd be that easy. Alright, I'm gonna cut to when I figure it out. Alright, welcome back. I have not tested this yet, but I'm pretty sure I figured it out. Okay, so it says I'm supposed to...
It reads, to leave the temple, bow to the deity of the order.
Okay, the audio clip was clipped off. But I believe the deity of the order is Cthulhu. And here's the thing, okay. So first things first, alright, you have these symbols here.
It's some sort of secret code.
Alright, it's broken. But you can piece it together just by looking at the parts and putting them where they're supposed to be. There's the first two that go up there, and then there's the bottom right, or like the top right of the next one at the top, and then you go down, and then there's the top of that one, and then there's continued. Okay, so yeah, you can transcribe these down, which I've done. I have them written down on my piece of paper right now. Now, what do you actually do with them? Here's the thing. If you look at these, alright, so on the bottom is the symbols that correspond to the buttons on the back of these statues. and above them is a symbol, or the symbols that correspond to what I just transcribed from that broken stone tablet. Now the thing is though, between these different statues, the symbol on that stone tablet that corresponds to the symbols on the statue are different. So, for example, look at the Triforce symbol on the right. You see you have a bunch of circles? It's the one with a bunch of circles that it corresponds to. Now, if we look at a different one... Now you see the Triforce symbol thing does not correspond to the one with a bunch of round things. So I believe what I need to do, which I've already done, is transcribe the symbols, step one. Step two, figure out which ones you need to press. Figure out which button corresponds to what. So depending on which statue's corresponding symbol you use would change which symbols you actually press, if that makes any sense. I'm sure there's a better way to state that, but that's about the best I can do. Okay, so going down, just going based off the code given by Cthulhu. First one is... Triforce. Then, rectangle. Rectangle thing. Then, Triforce. God, I hope this is right. Then, circle thing, which is this. Then, Triforce. And, circle thing. Well, fuck.
The doors are tightly sealed.
Okay, hold on. I already have transcribed down Dagon's symbols, so let's just do it based on Dagon. Maybe Dagon is their deity, I don't know. I kind of thought they worshipped, like, all of them, but I'm not really sure. Okay, let's go off of that. So first one is this. Next one is rectangle thing. Then this again. Then Triforce. Then this again. And then Triforce. Okay, it's Dagon. I mean, I guess I have seen Dagon mentioned more than Cthulhu.
It's a statue of Hydra.
But I've also seen Hydra mentioned a lot, so I don't know. Anyway, whatever, it worked. This looks like a sacrificial room. Do I really want to walk in here? Well, I don't have any choice, so... Yeah, I don't like the look of this room.
This plinth would have held the tablets of Dagon. Marsh must have taken them with it.
Oh. Well, I'm only about 20 minutes...
I can hear running water. These must be old smuggling tunnels leading out to the harp.
It's so weird that the audio is cut off at the end. Leading to the harp... And then it just stops. I'm really curious what is going on in the game to cause that. Like I was saying, well, since I had to stop to solve that puzzle and transcribe tablets, I'm only 20 minutes behind Marsh. Well, shit. A dangerous voyage. By far our greatest... okay. Damn it, I actually wanted to read that.